a NYC female student sentenced to 1 year in Dubai. What did she do? Elizabeth De Los Santos, 21-year-old NYC student facing a 1 year sentence in a Dubai prison. It's following 3 months of detainment for touching the arm of an airport security guard. After being told she would need to remove a post-surgical garment, she reached out and touched a guard's arm while pleading for help from a friend. This would come to cost her upwards of $50,000 in expenses and a prison sentence. Los Santos' ordeal began on July 14th as she and a friend were heading home to New York from a vacation in Istanbul. Their initial itinerary had them connecting home through Paris, but they changed the flight to transfer in Dubai so they could see the famous city during a 10-hour layover. New York Post has the story. While passing through security, Dubai airport staff requested that Los Santos remove a waist compressor she was required to wear after a recent surgery. Shown to a private booth, female staff members removed the compressor, but Los Santos' mother told Detained in Dubai they were rough. They hurt her daughter, still healing from those surgery scars. They also laughed at her. And when she asked for help to put the complicated garment back on, they refused. I was feeling uncomfortable and afraid. I felt really violated, Los Santos said. As staff continued to ignore her pleas for help, Los Santos leaned past the security guard, blocking her way, and called out for her friend to come and help her. I gently touched her arm to guide her out of the way, then desperately started crying to my friend for help, she told Detained in Dubai. Los Santos was then detained in a room for hours as the security guard she touched filed a complaint against her and wasn't allowed to leave until she signed a form written in Arabic. When she returned to the airport later to catch her flight to New York, she was informed of the travel ban filed against her and was forced to remain in the country until the charges against her were heard in court. After she had to stay in hotels for weeks, a judge allowed her to pay $10,000, about 2,700 US, and be on her way. But Dubai prosecutors appealed the ruling, and she was finally sentenced to a year in prison on Monday. U.S. State Department has only stated on Sunday that they are aware of the detainment of a U.S. citizen in Dubai, but no further comments. Detained in Dubai, a UAE civil and criminal justice specialist organization has been advocating for Los Santos and calling for her immediate release, its founder, Raja Sterling, comments. Elizabeth only intended to transit through Dubai for 6 hours, but she's been there for months on end and has lost $50,000 in expenses and lawyer's costs. She's now been told she has a 1 year prison sentence, but that if all goes well, she will only be detained until she can book a flight out of the UAE. On top of being humiliated, traumatized by airport staff, Elizabeth has suffered months of being forced to stay in an expensive country, pay expensive lawyers, and miss out on her university studies. Is this the kind of transport hub that people would want to choose? She's not the only U.S. citizen who has fallen foul of the country's backwards justice system, detained in Dubai. As I said, Mayor, this is a scary one. It sounds like one that was a bit panic-filled. You know, you have a young woman traveling internationally, place she's never been, uncomfortable post-surgery. And according to these details, those who were in charge seemed to take glee, delight in her discomfort, and then wanted to do more. What do you make of that? I've never been to Dubai. I don't know if you have.
Yeah, listen, I am I'm always cautious of telling people, especially my sisters or any women that I'm related to or care about, traveling certain places just because of things like this that can happen. This is unrealistic, unbelievable for people who think, who probably were coming back from a great vacation thinking they had a time to enjoy something that they've seen on social media that looks beautiful. But everything that looks beautiful is not, and also you need to be careful. I'm not Rodna, and I don't have the experience to say that their legal system is backwards. I would say, though, there is a high tolerance for Americans being locked up in these countries. And people sometimes, we've seen entertainers and musicians go over there and have a pill, a prescription pill, and be locked up for carrying drugs. I just tell people, just be careful when you're traveling outside of countries and understand, one, their culture, but also their laws and their history. I tell people I'm not interested in going to China, for instance, because I know the high tolerance for seeing a dark-skinned Black person be abused or sexually molested over there. So I have no interest of being in that country. So I tell people all the time, before you go places, because of you've seen it on Instagram and some people doing it, make sure you understand where you are in the culture and the laws, because this, I couldn't even wrap my head around this idea that you made someone remove a medical device simply to laugh and then watch them suffer through trying to be redressed. And then you literally charge them in a language that you know they don't understand. Unbelievable.
Yeah, it is. It's unbelievable. It is, as you said, scary, but I think you're right. Everything that's shiny and everybody has a story. Oh, I've been 10 times. Do your homework. If you're going to take that long flight, do your homework first. And I don't mean to, I'm not blaming her. Okay. She's supposed to have a layover and build us this fascinating, money filled, magical place. And now she just wants to get home. Caution.